Good morning to all my BBA second year students. Now today we'll be learning the subject of business communication skills. In the last video of the last class, we already learned about the functions of business communication skills. What are the functions or the characteristics of business communication skills? In this class, we'll learn the role and importance of business communication skills. How a business communication helps our organization in achieving its required goal, we will learn in this video. Now coming down to the slide, role and importance of business communication. Business communication plays a vital role in shaping and coordinating better understanding, planning, execution and implementation among internal and external sources of an organization. Now, what is the vital role in shaping and coordinating? Now, every person who joins or comes in an organization is not well shaped. So shaping and coordinating of employees, shaping and coordinating of employees around within an organization and around an organization. Within an organization, it is declared to be as the internal sources of organization or the internal part of an organization, and external sources means with competitors, with outsiders, with investors, with shareholders. The communication helps in maintaining a bridge or a combining unit with all the units which are available in the surrounding of an organization. The following below are the roles and importance of business communication. Now coming down to the first point, that is exchanging information. Now, the main aim or the main motto of communication, we can say, is exchanging of information. Why communication is used? Because it is used for the exchange of information. The information which is provided by the sender to the receiver is exchanged through the means of communication. So, communication provides a vital role or plays a vital role in the exchange of information, that is thoughts, views, ideas, opinions, gestures, symbols, eye contact, body language, etc. Now, exchanging of information. Communication is mainly exchange of information between two or more parties. Through communication, organization exchange information with internal and external parties. Now, what is internal parties and external parties? Internal parties are the internal environment, the employees, the management, the CEOs. There are three levels. Basically, there are three levels of management, that is top level, middle level and lower level. So all the three levels of management, the CEOs of the company, the management level of the company, the workers of the company, everyone does provide with the information. Information in the sense, the views, ideas, opinions, and sharing, passing of information from one person to another. And let us come to the external part. What is the external part or the external parties? Now, the external part is usually, we say it as external part, we convey it as the investors, the shareholders, the competitors, the government. So these are the external parties of an organization and the internal parties of an organization. So it provides various information to the external parties as well as the internal parties. So combining those internal and external sources is also done through the process of communication. Now, coming down to back to the slide, as communication is dynamic in nature, it attains of goals in an organization, helps in attainment of goals in organization. Now, what is dynamic in nature? Dynamic in nature means it plays a vital role or a certain role which adopts the crucial part of an organization, which adopts a crucial part of an organization. Dynamic role means it's determined for the attainment of objectives of an organization. Attainment of objective means every organization, whether it may be commercial or non-commercial, have some certain goals and objectives for which the organization is being run throughout the years. So attainment of those goals and objectives is very important, and communication plays a vital role in that expansion of, achievement of goals and objectives of an organization or a business. Now, coming down to the second point, that is preparing plans and policies. Now, what is the preparation of plans and policies? In every organization, there are certain rules, plans, policies which are planned ahead of the year, ahead of a particular year. So, planning those policies, plans, and procedures, and to make them realistic, or make them implement in the organization, it needs communication. So, communication plays a role in implementing, or you can say planning. Planning means communication is provide the data for the planning structure. Now, planning is done on the basis of the previous year data and data, or you can say information. So, that communication provides the previous year data and information to the manager or the management of the company. That management or the manager of the company comes with the data and information of previous year and plans accordingly, the policies, the plans, the execution which has to be go on within a year. So that is done through the process of communication. Coming down to the next point, that is execution of plans and policies. Now, what is the execution of plans and policies? After the planning of plans and policies, planning is done by the part of the management. Now, what is execution? Making the employees to follow that plans and policies. Execution means making the employees to follow the plans and policies. Now, every organization has certain different sets of plans and policies which have to be followed in a certain time period. So, making the employees follow the plans and policies is done through the process of communication. Now, plans and policies are planned and can be executed only through the process of communication. When we let know the employees that these are the change plans and policies of an organization and these has to be implemented or implemented in a coming year session or an academic session. So, the execution of these plans and policies is done in a better way through the communication of these plans and policies. Communicating these plans and policies to the employees from the level of management. So, the execution of plans and policies is done in a timely manner, in a well-maintained manner, and in a better effective manner through the process of communication. Now, the next point is increasing employees' efficiency. Communication helps in increasing employees' efficiency through plans, policies, rules, direction, and other complex. Now, employee efficiency. When an employee feels homely in the environment, homely certainly in its environment or workplace. When an employee feels homely and certainly in his workplace, it provides with certain rules, policies, procedure, which is familiar to him, which is familiar and also in the form of his abilities, also in the set of his abilities, then the employee's efficiency directly or indirectly increases. When a person is getting about, a person is giving his ability to do something to 100% and getting rewards in return, getting rewards or getting certain prizes in return, then the efficiency of the employee or the motivation of the employee doing his work obviously increases. So, it provides a certain help or boost employee productivity and employee working for the achievement of employee efficiency. Now, different procedures, plans, rules, and directions are provided by the company or provided by the management to the employees. And following those to resolve every complex matter, to understand the better working procedures, to understand the better company procedures, employee always have the plans and procedures and regulation laid out by the management. So, with help of those plans, procedures, and rules and directions for the complex matters and the simplest matter, an employee can give his 100% ability of doing a work. So 100% efficiency can be achieved through the process of communication from an employee. Coming down to the next point, that is achieving goals. Now, goals of communication helps in employees at all level be conscious and attentive. Now, communication and goal achieving. Communication, one part, it is the one part and the most important part of communication is business communication, is coming together, the group of people who are coming together, coordinating together, integrating together to attain certain objectives, certain objectives of the company, certain objectives or goals of the company. Now, coming down to the business communication, it achieving goals. What is achieving goals? Now, every company has certain goals to accomplish, certain goals to fulfill, certain goals to provide the betterment or for the future of the company. Now, communication plays a vital role in it. Communication plays a vital role in it at all levels. At all levels, whether it may be the top level management, medium level management, or the lower level management, conscious and attentive. With the help of communication, our employee becomes conscious and attentive of all the surrounding activities going on in the organization. All the surrounding activities going on in the organization, whether it may be a productive or non-productive activity, he is aware and conscious of all the activities going on in an organization. So it ensures timely accomplishment of jobs and easy achievement goals. Now, through the process of communication, with example, if I cannot perform certain tasks, now while communicating to my superiors or my manager, I can perform the task in a better way. So through the help of communication, I can maintain my record of doing the task in a correct manner, in a timely manner, and in a more accurate manner. So communication plays a vital role in maintaining the attentiveness and consciousness of the employees. So achieving goals, because an employee is always hired in an organization to achieve certain goals or help the organization to achieve certain goals. Now, communication plays a vital role or a process in which an employee communicates with the other employees or his superior or his subordinates to perform better, which helps in directly or indirectly achieving goals of an organization. Coming down to the next point, that is solving problems. Solving problems through various communication channels. The manager can inform about the various routine and non-routine problems of an organization. Accordingly, necessary actions are taken to solve the problem. Now, how can a manager belonging to the middle level management can know the problems of the lower level management? It is through communication. If the lower level management can inform the middle level management through the process of communication or business communication that they are having certain problems of routine and non-routine problems. Routine and non-routine problems means daily problems, day-to-day problems, and the problems we turn out right day-to-day, routine and non-routine problems. Then only the management level or the manager comes to know about the problems which arises in the routine level and non-routine level of an organization. And he can solve accordingly. So the communication plays a role in solving the problems of various levels also. Various levels and the various problems. So if an employee belonging to the lower level of management is restricted to communicate with the middle level management, then the problems may arise and it may come by the conflict or misunderstanding among employees of lower level. So if the problem is availed and can be communicated to the middle level, the problem is solved at the beginning stage only. So communication is a better option to resolve misunderstanding, conflicts, and also the problems within employees and the problems relating to routine and non-routine problems. Routine means day-to-day problems that arises, and non-routine problems are various non-day-to-day problems that arises in our organization. So solving problems is a major part of communication. With better communication skills or the better communication and business organization, the problems can be solved at the initial level or the beginning level without going into a more rational level. Now, coming down to the next point, that is making decisions. Making decisions in time requires update information through effective communication. A manager can collect information from different corners and make the best decision. Now, the work of a manager is to provide information to the upper level of management or the top level of management for decision making process. Now, how does a manager collect information from all the corners? Through effective relation or effective communication with his employees or subordinates. Being a manager, a person should be friendly enough, a person should be respectful enough, a person should have a better communication skills to achieve the information from every sector and every corner of an organization. And so on, from the management level, it is passed to the top level management, and from the top level management, the decision is made. The decision making process begins. So we can say the decision making process is made by collecting all the corner informations and all the available information in an organization, and it is well maintained, or we can say as it is passed on by the lower level to middle level to top level of management for decision making process. Now, coming down to the next point, that is improving industrial relation. Now, what is industrial relation? Industrial relation is relation between the workers and the management at a workplace. Workers and the management. Now, the management belongs to the top level of management and the workers belong to the lower level of management. So communication or the relation between the two levels and the middle level management is excluded in this part. Middle level plays a bridge between. The middle level management plays a bridge between the top level management and the lower level management. So the manager level or the boss level is to be effective enough or communicative, or maybe use an effective communication part or effective communication in maintaining or to provide with the less gap between the top level management and the lower level management. So the industrial relation is usually between the top level management and the lower level management. That is the industrial relation. Good industrial relation, if the lower level management or the worker level management is able to communicate to the management level or the top level management, then it becomes very easy, or it becomes very organized of an organization to have a better results for a business success. Now, if all the levels of management works together in a firm and systematic manner, then it is very favorable to the business and becomes it very favorable and very beneficial to the business. Now, maintaining the lower level managements with the top level management is the work of the middle level management. The managers, the boss or the superiors have to play the vital role or the bridge between the top level management and the lower level management. So it maintains a systematic record of everything. It maintains a systematic form of everything, and which is always beneficial to the part of the business. It provides profit to the business. So better communication between the top level management and the lower level management is called as industrial relation, and which has to be well maintained by an organization to accomplish or achievement of goals or to make a business success. Now, coming down to the next part, that is publicity of goods and services. Now, in the modern day, every other manufacturer is producing goods or producing goods or products. Now, producing goods or product is the first part, but the secondary is to sell the goods and product. Now, how can a manufacturer sell a goods and products? Through communicating to its customers. Now, communication plays a vital role also in the selling of product. Selling of product, that is through marketing and advertisement. What is advertisement and marketing? Marketing and advertisement is the part of communication. It is a part of communication where a producer of the product communicate with the consumer of the product. Where the producer of the product communicate with the consumer of product to buy his product. That is through the means of advertisement or marketing. You can say as through the means of advertisement. So advertisement is a mass media of communication. So buying, so publicity of goods and services can be well done with a better way of communication. If communication is better and well maintained, then it provides with the selling of goods and services in a very high manner and well maintained manner. So coming down to the next one, that is removing controversies. Now, controversies, controversies we can say as when we have a communication, or you can say when we have we have a contractual basis with the outside parties, or we have a dealings with outside parties. Effective communication allows smooth flow of information from various parties involved in negotiation. Now, there may be competitors in the market for our products. There may be competitors of the market for our the same organization or the same business. Now, how do we deal with that competition or the competition of the product or competition of the same business? Now, while communicating or negotiation with the other party or the outside party, the effective communication, the mannerly and effective communication plays a vital role with the outside parties. The effective communication, the smooth flow of communication, the smooth flow of information can provide a better background or understanding for the outside parties with our business, which provide a result of no conflicts, controversies or disagreement between the parties, and everything can be resolved in a negotiation with the outside parties. Now, coming down to the next point, that is enhancing employee satisfaction. If there is a fair flow of information of an organization, it certainly brings the mutual understanding between the management and the employee. Such understanding enhances the situation of employee satisfaction. Now, what is employee satisfaction? Employee satisfaction is when your employees are satisfied with the providings of the company. Providings of the company means with the incentives, with the promotions, with the extra gifts and particulars of the company. So employee satisfaction is that. Employee satisfaction is, you can say in a simple way, that an employee is happy and satisfied with the work done and the reward which he got for the work done by him. So employee satisfaction, with a better way of communication, it creates a bridge between the management and the fair flow of information from the management and to the employees. Such enhance the understanding, the way the management supports the employees, the employees also supports the management, and it creates a bridge or level of binding unit of between the management and the employees, which enhance employee satisfaction. Employee satisfaction is nothing but the rewards which an employee gets in an orderly manner for the work done by him. So employee satisfaction plays an important role in the enhancement of the company, in the enhancement of the ability of the employee, and also in the loyalty of an employee. So we can say as employee satisfaction, enhancing employee satisfaction is well maintained and done through the process of communication. If the management have proper communication, understanding and mutual understanding levels with the employees, then the form of employee satisfaction is much higher than the where the communications are not so effective. Coming down to the last point, enhancing loyalty. Now, what is enhancing loyalty? Effective communication helps the manager to be aware of the performance of his subordinates and accordingly judge the loyalty of the subordinates. Now, what is the loyalty of the subordinates? Now, whether the employee is faithful enough to his superior, whether the employee is faithful enough for his superior is the loyalty of the employees. Now, better communication. If my superior or my boss is a better being, better human being, he communicates with me, understand my problems, I'll be loyal to him. I'll be in the work-wise loyal to him. So that is the main concept of enhancing loyalty, that a communication process or a communicating thing or a communication part plays a vital role in maintaining the employee's loyalty. Employee's loyalty, whether the subordinate is trustworthy, whether it has a better bonding with the other employees, whether he is listening to his superiors and the work is done on time or not. So this communication provides a flow, or communication provides you can say as a helping hand to the employees or and the management to combine together to make a mutual understanding between them to achieve organizational goals and also to achieve subordinates or employee loyalty. So that's all for today's class. We'll continue with the next class in the next session.